Dear viewers and students, in the series of the videos about the SSLC social science, today I am going to deal a new chapter, that is the extension of British rule in India. Here the Britishers began to extend their power in India. Already they got control over the some of the important parts of India after the battles of Carnatic Wars and Battle of Plassey, Buxar. These three important events, after these three events, they got control over the some of the important parts of India, particularly the Bengal region. The Bengal region came into their control, and now they are going to extend their power in the other parts of the India. The main hurdles in the expansion of their power in India were particularly in the southern as well as eastern and western parts of India, particularly the Mysore kings, then Marathas and Sikhs. In the Mysore, Hyder Ali, Tipu Sultan and Maratha rulers, and Sikhs were the hurdles in expansion of their power. Now, in order to take control these areas in their power, they adopted two important policies that we have to remember here. Two important policies what they adopted in consolidation of their power and extension of their power. One is a subsidiary alliance. Next, we will know about that what type of policy that was. And next is a doctrine of lapse. These two policies they adopted in the extension of their power. And when they adopted these policies and they began to extend their power, that led to controversies between the native rulers as well as the British. And that is responsible for the important wars and battles which took place. And those here we are going to know about. Here the wars which took place between the British as well as Mysore, they are called as Anglo-Mysore Wars. And the wars which took place between the Marathas and British, that is called as Anglo-Maratha Wars. And then those wars which took place with the Sikh, they are called as Anglo-Sikh Wars. Here these wars, in the, as far as the Anglo-Mysore War are concerned, we will know about those wars in the coming chapter. That is, now we are going to know about two important wars, that is the Anglo-Maratha Wars and Anglo-Sikh Wars. In that category, first try to know about the first Anglo-Mysore War. First Anglo-Maratha War. This first Anglo-Maratha War is an important event, and there are many reasons also responsible for this war. Here, what is the important one is, the Marathas installed Shah Alam, the Mughal emperor, and they installed him and empowered him. But here, the Britishers already wanted to dethrone this Shah Alam. At that time, Marathas went to help the Shah Alam. And because of this one, here Shah Alam gave Kora and Allahabad. Marathas. And earlier, after the Battle of Buxar, the same places were given by the Shah Alam to the British. But the same places were given now to the Marathas. This was the reason for the controversy between the Marathas and the British. It led to the rivalry. It led to the rivalry between the Marathas and British because of these two important places. Now, here the stage is ready for the controversy. Now, the Britishers were waiting to enter into the controversy as well as clashing with the Marathas. How that was came into picture? Here, the scene is ready now. Here, after Madhava Rao, here, after the death of Madhav Rao, now the throne, the Marathas, Narayan Rao became the Peshwa. After Madhav Rao, Narayan Rao became the Peshwa. But now one of a person here, Raghunath Rao. This Raghunath Rao wanted to become the Peshwa, and he tried to, that is, make different kind of efforts. In those efforts, he killed Narayan Rao. Raghunath Rao killed Narayan Rao. But these the people there, and particularly the nobles in Marathas, they never wanted Raghunath Rao to be a Peshwa and prevented him. And they make the son of Narayan Rao, Madhav Rao II as the Peshwa. And he was a very small infant. Dhyan also, that his child was made as a Peshwa, and the regent was the Nana. Here, this controversy further led to Raghunath Rao went to sought the help of British. Raghunath Rao went to get the help of British in order to take revenge against the son of Narayan Rao, Madhav Rao, and here, in order to get power, this person do this activity. That led to the war between the Marathas as well as the British, and that war started from the year 17, that is 75, and it continued for some time, and after that, that is 1782. Here, in this war, the Britishers were able to defeat the Marathas, and particularly after this one, here Madhav Rao II has to enter into the treaty, means his regent enter into the treaty with the British, and that treaty is called as the Treaty of Salbai. This treaty is very important, you have to remember. And after this treaty, now again this Madhav Rao was made as a Peshwa. He was accepted as a Peshwa by the British, and Raghunath Rao was given a pension. And by this one, here the first Anglo-Maratha war came to an end. Okay, it is about this one. Here the reason was the Kora and Allahabad for the rivalry, and later the scene was ready. Madhav Rao, so the death of Madhav Rao was one of important event. After him, that is Narayan Rao became the Peshwa, but Raghunath Rao, that is wanted to become Peshwa, and that's why he killed Narayan Rao. And after the death of Narayan Rao, the people of that is Marathas never accepted Raghunath Rao, and Madhav Rao II was made as a Peshwa. And by this one, Raghunath Rao went to take the help of the British. Then here the war took place for a long time here, and in the ultimately here this was a victory for the British, and the Treaty of Salbai was signed, and the first Anglo-Maratha war came to an end. Okay, after this, let us try to know about one of important, already told you, the two important policies which were adopted for the extension of British rule in India, that is the doctrine of lapse and subsidiary alliance. First, try to know about subsidiary alliance. This subsidiary alliance is one of the important policy, and this policy was made by Lord Wellesley is the maker of this policy. And what is the aim of this policy? The main aim is the military protection to native rulers. And on what basis they give military protection? There are many important conditions of this subsidiary alliance. Conditions: if a ruler or a native ruler is going to accept this subsidiary alliance, what are the important conditions he has to fulfill? First condition is, he has to keep British army a regime of a piece of army, the that has to be kept by the native ruler. Any person who accept this subsidiary allowance. And after that, the next important condition is that has to a British resident will be in the court of the native ruler. He will look after, he will supervise what are the activities which are going in that, that is native rulers. And that is the second condition. Then here next is not to appoint any European means any other country person, French or any other one, without the permission of this British. It is the third condition, not to appoint any officer, European officer. It is the third condition. And next is here, for any kind of treaties, the Governor General permission is needed. If the native ruler is going to enter in any kind of treaty, any kind of agreement or a pact with others, at that time they has to get the permission of the Governor General of India. That is also one of the condition. And next is here, company, if a native ruler fulfill all these points, means keeping British army in their, that is a native, that is empire or kingdom, as well as appointing a British resident there, and not to appoint any officer, a European officer, and taking permission for any kind of agreement and pact. At that time, if he fulfill all these conditions, what the British will give? The British will give the protection and security. Protection and security means if any other native ruler attack over this person who accepted subsidiary alliance, the Britishers will come to help him. It is about the subsidiary alliance, the conditions, as well as according to this subsidiary alliance, many kingdoms were joined with the the British Empire. The first person to accept this subsidiary alliance was the Nizam of Hyderabad. And the same policy they went on imposing upon other parts of the, that is here, this is about subsidiary alliance. Now we left after the first Anglo-Maratha war, now the second Anglo-Maratha war. Second Anglo-Maratha war. Second Anglo-Maratha war. Here we have to know about the reasons for Second Anglo-Maratha War, and the reason is differences among the Maratha chiefs. Differences among Marathas or Maratha chiefs is responsible for the Second Anglo-Maratha War. What is the reason? Here, the Holkar Yeshwantrao attacked, that is the Sindhia. Attack the Sindhia chiefs, and that is the Daulat Rao. As well as he also attacked upon the Peshwa Balaji Rao. When he attacked upon the Peshwa Balaji Rao, this Balaji Rao, in order to get away from the attack of this Holkar, he sought the help of British. Now the British has got an opportunity to interfere in the internal matters of Marathas, and it is because of the invitation of Peshwa Balaji Rao. And now this Wellesley, already he is known for one of the important policy, that is the subsidiary alliance. Now he got an opportunity. Now he said, that is a put a condition before Balaji Rao, that if we accept the subsidiary alliance, then only the British will help them. And now that Balaji Rao enter into the treaty, and that is called as the Treaty of Basin. Treaty of Basin. And according to this treaty, now Balaji Rao accepted subsidiary alliance, and now the Britishers came to help this one. And when this Treaty of Basin was signed, now the Holkar and Sindhia and others, they were not happy with the act of Balaji Rao, that is accepting of subsidiary alliance. Now they make an alliance. Other powers, that is except Balaji Rao, they make an alliance, and now they are ready to attack over the British, and that is responsible for the further war, and that war took place from 1803 to 1805. And in this battle here, the Marathas were not able to face the attack of the British, and ultimately they had to lost from in the hands of British, and this is responsible for their defeat. Now, after this war took place, now the Wellesley, he is considered as a warmonger. Warmonger means he always in a, that is fighting the wars, and this act of Wellesley is considered as a financial burden upon the British and company. That's why they called back Wellesley back to, that is England, and now the Wellesley's policy is considered as a burden on the company. It is about the end of Second Anglo-Maratha War. And after that, let us go to the another important war, that is the Third Anglo-Maratha War. Third Anglo-Maratha War. Here we have to know about what is the reason for the Third Anglo-Maratha War. Already the Peshwa Balaji Rao accepted subsidiary alliance, but now he came to realize that it is nothing but a surrender in front of the British. Now he tried to get independent from the control of the British. That is the main reason, that is the Marathas wanted to be independent from the British. It is the main reason. And in that one, here the Peshwa Balaji Rao attacked Pune. What is in Pune? There it is a British residency. And in that Pune was attacked by Balaji Rao. And further, others also went and joined with this person, Appa Saheb also joined with the Balaji Rao, and even the other persons also joined. Like that, the revolt was continued. Appa Saheb and others also joined. Now here, this led to a more war, that is a fighting between the Marathas as well as the British. Ultimately, the Britishers were responsible. To defeat all the Marathas, and all Marathas were defeated in the hands of British, and now the Maratha power came to an end. Here, this result, what is the result of this Third Anglo-Maratha War was the Peshwa post was cancelled. And Balaji was given pension. And the descendant of Shivaji, he was made as a king of Satara. Pratap Simha was made as a king of Satara. By this one, here the Third Anglo-Maratha, that is Maratha War, came to an end, and it is the end of the power of the Marathas. Till now, we already came to know about the First Anglo-Maratha War, Second Anglo-Maratha War, and Third Anglo-Maratha War. And now, in the policy of British extension of their empire, that led to the controversy between the Sikhs also. Let us try to know about the Anglo-Sikh War. Anglo Sikh war. Anglo-Sikh wars. Particularly here we are to know about one of important person by name Ranjit Singh. This Ranjit Singh had a friendly relation with the Britishers, and by this kind of relation he saved his kingdom from the attack of British from a long time. And after the Ranjit Singh, next his person who became the ruler was Dilip Singh. This Dilip Singh became the ruler, and during this Dilip Singh there was a political controversy. Political controversy, it is the reason for the Anglo-Sikh war. Political controversy and political unrest was taking place in Punjab at the Sikh Empire. At that time, the Britishers got an opportunity. Britishers attacked. British attacked Punjab, and in this war, he has to face the attack as well as he was defeated. And after the defeat of this British, that is Dilip Singh, now this Punjab was taken into the control of Britishers. And here one of a treaty was signed, that is called as the Lahore Agreement. And according to this Lahore Agreement, now here the Punjab was taken into the control of Britishers, and de facto rulers, they became the de facto rulers of Punjab, and for namesake Dilip Singh was accepted as the king. And now this after the this scene, a next scene is going to happen here. The role of Chhatar Singh and Mul Raj, these two persons are responsible to revolt against the British. They make a revolt as well as try to get the independence of the Sikh, but because of the traitors who were there, and due to those traitors they had to face the attack from the British. And due to the role of traitors, Chhatar Singh and Mul Raj has to surrender. They had to surrender in front of the British, and ultimately now the Dalhousie took the control of the whole Punjab, and Punjab was merged into the British Empire. It is the story of the Anglo-Sikh wars and the story of Punjab. And after this, the last concept in this chapter is the doctrine of lapse. Doctrine of lapse. As already in the beginning I told you, two important policies which were adopted by the British for the extension of empire. One is subsidiary alliance and another one is doctrine of lapse. And this doctrine of lapse is introduced by Lord Dalhousie. He is the maker of this policy, and it was started in the year 1848. What is the main aim of this policy? That we have to know here. What is the aim of the policy? The aim of the policy is that to integrate the princely states as the native rulers. Integrate princely states into British Empire is the aim of this doctrine of lapse. What is the, according to this policy, here any native ruler who is having no natural heir or natural, that is his own child is not there, if he is having adopted child, that adopted child will not be accepted as the ruler. It is the one of important one. Adopted children's of king, not legal, that is a heir to throne. They have no legality, they have no legal right to become the king, and this is the one of important condition of doctrine of Laplace. And according to this doctrine of Laplace, many kingdoms were annexed. Among those were the Satara, Sambalpur, Nagpur, Udaipur, Jhansi, and so many kingdoms were annexed according to the doctrine of Laplace. And this doctrine of Laplace further lead to a very important event in our Indian history, that is the 1857 revolt. Why? Because the doctrine of Laplace is having a very greater impact upon the native rulers, and that led to the further war here. This is about the brief that is sketch of the extension of British rule in India. And here I am going to conclude this chapter, and further we are going for the other chapters also. And in the last, I want to tell you that here subscribe our channel as well as like our videos and encourage us with different kind of support and comments. Thank you.